What's up, everybody? Welcome to the pre-show. It's September. Can you believe it? Oh, my God. It's crazy. Hi. Where's everybody from? Our neighbor in Indiana. What's going on? Hey, Tonda. We got Houston, Maryland, Dallas. What's going on? Tennessee, Utah, Cali. What up? The ATL, of course. Charlotte. Hello. Happy Friday, everybody. Yeah. Tower Power Night. Can you believe it? I'm so excited. Lots going on tonight. Huge show. There's a million people on tonight's show. So if I go over, what are you going to do? Upper Marlboro, Maryland. I have to say it slowly. Upper Marlboro. Or you could say it like that. Renee, what up? Dayton, Ohio. Arizona. Lots of Texas. We got Betty in Seattle. Hello. And Makiko. Hello in Japan. What's going on? Saturday morning over there. It's Saturday morning. It's Saturday morning in Japan. Hey, I'm drinking Bum City wine tonight. Oh, yeah. Did you know about it? It's so good. Okay. Lots of North Carolinians here. And a South Carolinian. Hello in Myrtle Beach. Yeah, what's going on? I got a little cartoon on tonight. It's the funk band, you know. T.O.P. in the house. We got, it's funk night. It's unofficial funk night. You know what I'm saying? It's all about the horns. Very, very excited about everything happening tonight. What else? What else is going on? We got New Jersey, New York. New York. Cecil in Sacktown. Tony in C-Town. Where is C-Town? S-E-A town. I don't know. Springfield, Missouri. Hello. Hi, Jason. What's up, man? Of course, our smooth jazz family in San Diego. Good evening. Good early evening there, I should say. We got the Bay. We got the Bay. And of course, it's all about the East Bay tonight. You know what I'm saying? Tower of Power. Man, so cool, so cool. We got Birmingham, the Ozark Mountains of Arkansas. Welcome. Yes. All right. Maryland, North Carolina. Lots of North Carolina tonight. Marcus Anderson might have told all his friends. Good early after. Hey, Michael Grande from Hawaii. Aloha. Mahalo. Yeah. Of course, Chicago. What's up? Yeah. All right. Well, let me get things together here. We got 2 minutes. 2 minutes to showtime. This is the pre-show. I'm just saying hello. Hello, hello, hello. Oh, yeah. All right, stay right there. Lots going on tonight because I'm debuting a couple songs. I'm reaching back into my archives and pulling out some things that no one's ever heard tonight, too. So excited about that later in the show. Lots going on, I'm telling you. All right, let me get things together. Stay right there. Where else do you gotta go? Hello from Nazareth. Hi, Lori. New Orleans, and Rhode Island. Hello. Man, everybody's here tonight. Welcome, everybody. Okay. Here we go. Almost. Are you staying with it? I am. Okay, let me put that over there. Get your hat. All right, here we go. Ready? All righty. Hey, it's Brian Culbertson. We're live, and it's Friday night. Whoa! What's going on, everybody? Cheers! It's the Tower of Power edition. Are you ready for it? Oh, sang it.
It's Friday night.
You know the words.
It's Friday night.
That's right. September 4th.
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
What up? What up? We got the founding member of Tower of Power here tonight. Emilio Castillo is here with us. We got former singer Larry Braggs, drummer David Garibaldi, former sax man Euge Groove, and wine from Bump City. What up?
It's Friday night.
Roger Smith's Bump City.
It's Friday night.
Uh-huh. Sing it.
It's Friday night.
Yes. Oh, welcome, everybody. It's a big show tonight. A lot going on. But first, cheers to you. Oh, check out what I'm drinking. Yes. That's right. I got the horn in there. It's Tower Power Night. It's all about the horns, man. So we're drinking Bump City Wine Company, started by the keyboardist of Tower Power, Roger Smith. And tonight, you can get this 20% off. Oh, yes. So if you haven't had it, now's your chance. Go check it out. Oh, yeah. It's so good. Here, I'm drinking the red blend. That's right. So cheers to you. Here we go. Hope you got something good in your glass. Oh, man, it's drinking easy tonight. And I have a piece of hair sticking right up, don't I? Tell my hair to stay with it. I'm going to set this down. It's in these times, our hair is going to do what it do. You know what I'm saying? All right. So like I said, I got a lot of music tonight. Tonight's music is all about funk and horns. Paying tribute to one of my favorite bands. I'm talking about Tower of Power. We're going to be hearing from all the guys very, very shortly. But I want to start it off with a song from back in the day that I covered on my funk record. That's a funk with an exclamation point. Just in case you were curious. Okay. Are you ready? I think you know this one. Hey. What? And you can sing along, too. It's gonna be a sing-along show. Thank you. There it was. Hey, here's part one with my chat with Emilio Castillo. Founder of one of the most legendary bands of all time. I'm talking about Tower of Power. You guys have been going strong 52 years. It's unbelievable. Horn section, equally as legendary, played on hundreds of albums, inspired countless musicians, including myself and all of my records. I'm so happy you're here. Emilio Castillo, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good, Brian. Thanks for having me.
Man, it's good to see you here. I mean, going for 52 years, I know you guys started officially August 13th, 1968. Did you think we'd be in 2020 still going?
No, I had no vision then. I just loved playing music. I really loved having a band. That was really my thing. My biggest aspiration, when the guys I idled was this band called the Spiders.
Okay.
In the Bay Area. They're a really good, tight soul band with great background vocals,
yeah,
a really good horn section, and I wanted to be like them. And they got a gig at this bar in Sacramento, and I thought, man, if I could just get to Sacramento. You know, like that was as far as my vision went back in 68.
Wow. Well, I would say you definitely made it somewhere out of Sacramento.
Yeah.
So I know you grew up in Detroit, but moved to the Bay Area when you were, was it 11?
Yeah, 11 years old.
Yeah, yeah. And so you formed your own band. The first band you formed was called the Motowns, obviously influenced by where you grew up there in Detroit.
Yeah, it wasn't my first band, but okay, it was the band that became Tower of Power. You know, when I started, I was 14,
yeah,
and we played rock and roll, and you know, we were called the Roadrunners, and then the Extension 5, and the Gotham City Crime Fighters, and the Black Orpheus. And when we were the Black Orpheus, that's when we really got hip to soul music. And my mother was the manager, you know, because we were teenagers.
The momager.
Yeah, and she said, you know, if you're gonna be a soul band, you should call your band the Motowns because you're from Detroit. You know, my brother was in the band as well, and so we did. We were the Motowns, and when I hired Doc, he came in the band, and he was the first hippie I met. And you know, the times were changing, and we all started growing our hair long. And
yeah.
And the thing was the Fillmore West. Everybody wanted to get into the Fillmore West, so mm-hmm. we got an audition, but we knew we'd never be popular there with the name like the Motowns. So I picked the name off a list, Tower of Power.
That was on a list?
Yeah, it was a list of weird band names, you know, like Fromius Bandersnatch and Lothar and the
so
Hand
you just
People
started and, making names up and made a list of
well,
them.
We were doing a little recording in Hayward, California, and we were on a break, and I was sitting at the owner's office, and there was like a 3-page list of all kind of weird band names, and none of them would have worked, you know. But then I saw that name Tower of Power, and I walked out. I go to the guys, hey, what about Tower of Power? They're like, yeah, that's us.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, it makes sense because you have such a foundation of groove and mixed with the horns and the vocals on top. It's like this three-layered tower, I think, you know.
I guess.
I don't know.
Over the years, I've regretted picking that name. It seems, I don't know, somehow egotistical or something, but we're stuck with it at this point.
I mean, it works. So I know you wrote most of your songs with Doc. The two of you have written so many iconic songs over the years. I have to ask you, how do two sax players get together and write songs? You know, what's your process? All these funky syncopated rhythms, do you sing it? How do you make these songs?
Well, the rhythm thing is really more my bag of tricks.
Okay.
You know, I was doing that even before David Garibaldi got in the band. I used to think up weird beats.
Hmm.
And my brother was a drummer. And my brother, he was a good drummer, real solid, good groove.
Yeah.
But he didn't have the capabilities of like Garibaldi or anything. But he practiced incessantly. Hmm. And so I would make up these weird beats and I would just drill them on these beats. And we'd make up beats and put them to, you know, old soul tunes, or, you know, at that time, soul tunes that every band was playing, but we made it sound like our own, you know? And so when we started writing, me and Doc, You know, I would come up with beats and stuff like that. And Doc also, you know, he would say, you know, I like this song, I dig the beat. And I'd sort of take that beat and then change it a bit, you know. And sometimes I just come up with, you know, like I got a song that's a groove. I take it to the band and then Garibaldi would tell me, hey, you know, we could do this. And he'd play it for me and be some weird beat, you know. And I go, let's give it a shot.
Sounds good to you. Nice, yeah. Nice. So did you just like record yourself onto an old tape deck, or how did you just remember it and then sing it to the band, or how'd you do it?
Yeah, no recording.
No recording.
Not back then. No.
Just come into the band and like, hey, here's what I got.
Yeah, you know, I play guitar and keyboards, and Doc plays keyboards.
Yeah.
And we get together, and I mean, the first time we ever got together, we were listening to this album called "This Is My Country." By Curtis Mayfield in the Impressions. And there was a song with a high trumpet intro.
Yeah.
And we loved it. And we thought, we had Mick Gillette, you know, back then, you know.
Yeah.
And we said, we got to write a trumpet intro like that. So we wrote the intro. And then I was in love with this girl that was 6 years older than me. Mm-hmm. And she had broken my heart a couple of times, always telling me I was too young for her. And I said, you know, why don't we write a song called "You're Still a Young Man," and the guy would be telling the girl, no, I'm not too young, you know. And we just started writing. That's what we did.
Great stories, Emilio. Much more with Emilio later in the show. But right now, it's time to take a trip around the house or world. What? Around the house. Yeah, for real. Uh-huh. Hey, here's Euge Groove with some TLP stories.
Hi everyone out there in Brian Culbertson video land. Hi Brian, how you doing? Saxophonist Eugene Groove, aka Euge Groove. The reason I tell you who I am is you might not recognize me with the beard. I vowed to not shave my face or cut my hair until I can do another Euge Groove live gig, and I'm holding myself to it. Hopefully, it won't be with ZZ Top by the time we get to play live again. I'm sure it won't be. I'm sure we'll be back out there seeing you guys real soon. It's my pleasure to be on today and talk about a band that was so influential to me, not only listening to them, but actually being a member of Tower of Power. I learned so much with them. I started with the band in 1988 after I had just moved to Los Angeles. And Emilio, who's one of your guests today, taught me so much about music and how to put on a great show and so much about the music business. Not only that, but they helped me see the world for the first time as part of the Tower of Power Horns. We toured with Huey Lewis, my first trip to Europe and Australia with them, and I actually met my wife on that tour in Stockholm, Sweden. So I have them to thank a lot for that. They showed me some of the finer things in life, like some of the finer hotels. We played Seattle. I'll never forget staying at the Thunderbird Inn, where I tried to turn on the air conditioner and it actually fell out of the wall. It was one of my great memories. And also on a personal note, outside of music, Emilio was so helpful to me. I remember one time down in Harlingen, Texas, having a hard time getting our instruments on the plane, and the guy wasn't going to let us check them, and he wasn't going to let us put them under the plane, and somehow we had to carry our stuff through security and try to get them in the overheads, and the guy was waiting for us at the gate to give us more grief. And after we finally all got on the plane, Emilio went up to him and handed him a suppository and said, "I hope you feel better." Mimi, do you remember that story? Anyway, what a great band, Tower of Power. Glad to share some of those inside stories with you. And enjoy the music. It's got to be funky.
Could you imagine trying to turn on the air conditioner and it falls out? I've probably been at one of those hotels myself. Thanks, Euge. Be sure to check out Euge's brand new record. Just came out this summer called Sing My Song. Sing My Song. That was Dirty Dozen, the single on radio right now. So thanks, Euge. Yeah, man. So, as promised, I went back into my archives and found a song that was never released. So I thought it'd be cool to lay it on you guys tonight. So check it out. This actually features a vocalist, incredible vocalist by the name of Lewis Price, who used to sing with the Temptations. Check it out. I think you'll know this one. Yeah. Oh. Are you feeling it?
Don't you ever be sad. Lean on me. Our times get bad. When the day comes and you're down in a river of trouble, about to drown. I'm
Hold on. I'm coming. Ooh, that was fun. The applause. thanks, you guys. Yeah, my goodness. Hey, I need a drink after that. What is going on? Oh, yes. All right, let's talk about this. Let's talk about it. Yeah. Bump City. You know, that's the name of Tower's second record. So, let's do a little cheers. Uh-huh. Cheers, you guys. Mmm. And I got a little video from Roger, too. He's busy in the winery right now, like, as we speak. They're harvesting, they're bottling, they're doing their crush. All kinds of stuff is going on. They're out in Sonoma County in California. So, shall we hear from Roger? I think so. Check it out.
Everybody, this is Roger Smith, keyboardist with Tower of Power and owner of Bump City Wine Company. I just want to say cheers to you, Brian, and everybody watching. Hope you guys are staying safe and healthy. I know it's some trying times, and I hope you're enjoying the wine, okay? As you can see, this is a functioning winery. That's why all the noise is going on around. We're bottling, we're doing crush, so there's a lot of noise. Sorry about that, but cheers to you all. Stay safe, stay healthy.
Thank you, Roger. And right now, you know, you can get 20% off plus free shipping with 6 or more bottles, valid today through Monday, the end of Monday. So don't miss out. Give it a shot. Drink the red blend. They got a whole line of wine. Cab, Pinot Grigio, Chardonnay. I mean, Zinfandel. They got all kinds of stuff. So, yeah. I mean, you can stock up and get one of each or a case of each, whatever you want. This red is drinking. It is opened up halfway through the show. It is drinking very, very nicely right now. So cheers. Mm. Bump City Red. Mmm. Hey, here's more from Emilio Castillo. I know your first album, East Bay Grease, came out in the 70, right? So you must have recorded it in the late 60s. It's interesting listening to your, or re-listening to your catalog. Hearing that first album still has some of that production technique left over from the 60s with that reverb sound. But then yeah. Your second album, all of a sudden, 70s, it dries up and it gets tighter.
Yeah, the reverb sound was David Rubinson. Ah. He produced the record, and it was actually the first record that he engineered. Mm. He had a great engineer named Fred Cotero. Uh-huh. And, you know, we were kind of like the unknown little band. And he dug us because we were a soul band, and we were a good soul band.
Yeah, yeah.
But we weren't well known or anything. As a matter of fact, nobody knew us, you know. And so he had Fred set everything up.
Yeah.
And then he recorded it and he mixed it by himself. And too much reverb. But then we got to Memphis. We had signed with Warner's and we contacted Steve Cropper. We wanted to work with him. Uh-huh. When we got there, he had Ronnie Capone as the engineer. And Ronnie Capone, you know, they had a more dry sound on there. They were used to working with Al Jackson.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that kind of stuff. So they took David's drums and put all this foam on it and taped it. He hated the sound of those drums, you know. But then we sort of, you know, the next record, Tower of Power with What Is Hip, that's when I stepped into the production role, and we all sort of pitched in as a band, and yeah. we started aiming more towards what we actually sounded like live, you know.
Right. And that's what stuck. That's the iconic sound that we all know, you know. So that second record, Bump City, had You Got to Funkifies on it.
Yeah, and you recorded it.
Yes, I did. And I'm telling it was one of my all-time favorites, you know, growing up as a kid, listening to your music, being so inspired. You know, me being a trombone player, also loving the horn section. Should I do that song? I think I should. Hey, Larry, where are you? Larry Braggs, what's up?
Yeah!
Larry Braggs, everybody. Hey, check this out. Larry has a new single out everywhere right now called Confession. I mean, you know him for many years, front and tower power, and more recently with the Temptations, but he is solo right now with a brand new single. Go check it out, Confession. You gotta hear it. Larry Braggs. Thank you, Larry. Man, that was so much fun. He got me sweating now. He. Oh, my goodness. I hope you're having fun. I sure am. Cheers to you. Hey, shall we hear a little road story from back in the day from David Garibaldi? I think we should.
Mm-hmm. Hey, everybody. David Garibaldi here. Stories from the road. You know, stories from the road. Road is always kind of an interesting place. Many, many crazy things happen there. And it seems like in the early days, weird things happened more often than they do now. Now it's pretty normal when we tour. We're sort of older and a lot of weirdness, you know, is gone. But in those days, you know, like we're 23 years old, stuff like that. A lot of really crazy stuff. I remember the thing that comes to mind, one story that comes to mind, and there's a few, but the one that comes to mind in particular was we were playing at the Whiskey A Go-Go. It was one of our first trips to Los Angeles. And the Whiskey A Go-Go was a very popular venue in Hollywood. And so on this particular night, I decided that I was going to take acid. So the gig starts and somebody wants to sit in. He's a very famous rock and roll percussionist. And I'm not going to give you his name, but he came and he sat in. And the guys didn't like it. And so they were saying that it sounded like pots and pans. He was banging on pots and pans and all this stuff. So anyway, I think we played a couple sets. And I was pretty under the influence of this acid. And so I started to get really paranoid because I knew all the guys just hated what was going on. And during the set, I started hallucinating, and I was standing next to myself as I was playing, and I couldn't decide which one was me. So the set ends, I go upstairs, we go to the dressing room area upstairs, and I go to my buddy Skip, and I said, Skip, you gotta help me, man, I'm freaking out. So he laughed at me, and he walked away. And so there it is. I was left to spend the rest of the evening in Never Never Land. But just a really crazy little road story. One of the road Tower Power road vignettes from back in the day.
Are you kidding me? Standing next to himself. Wow. That's crazy. Yeah, I can't say I can relate to that one. But thanks, David. My goodness. Oh, yeah, yay. Well, hey, check this out. You know, I got to pay tribute now because I seriously owe a lot to this incredible group, Tower, I'm talking about. And mainly because they influence my music so much, like I mentioned earlier, in terms of the horn section. You know, I've talked a lot about loving the horns, and they're in so much of my music, as you know. So I thought I'd put together just a few clips of my favorite little horn section parts from my songs from throughout the year. So check this out. Mm-hmm. Get up. Always remember. Horn arrangement by Greg Adams. Hello. Thank you. played this one earlier.
Been around the house.
So, those were just a few little tastes of horn section parts from my songs throughout the years that were obviously inspired from Tower of Power. So thank you, Emilio. Thank you, Doc, and the whole band. You guys are amazing. So here's some more from Emilio. Talking about the horn section. So I want to talk about the horn section. I know you said you just loved hearing the soul bands with the horn section, and when Doc came in, it added the low end. I mean, you guys are literally the tightest horn section of all time. Something you always just had inside you, and you just wanted to make it as perfect as possible? Because I call it booty tight.
Yeah, as I said before, this band, the Spiders, they were a white soul band.
Yeah.
They had three horns. They were so tight. And that was it. I just like, I saw that. I was like, that's what I'm going to be. I'm going to do that.
I remember sitting in with you guys a couple times, and just the feeling behind me and around me was just like something I had never experienced before. I mean, you think, you know, you play with tight bands, but then playing with you guys, I was like, oh, wow, this is down to the, like, nanosecond tight.
Yeah, you know, I do a lot of sessions with other people and stuff, and sometimes we play live with other folks, too. We did a lot of touring with Huey Lewis and Little Feet, and, you know, we played with the Eurythmics. And I always come back from those gigs, and, you know, Garibaldi and me or Doc and me, I say, you know, we're so jaded, man, because we don't realize just how tight it is. You know, we're like, because we got it every night. You know, then I go play with another band, and I'm like, oh, we got a good thing going, you know?
Right. So when did people start calling you Mimi?
Oh, when I was a little boy.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, yeah, from birth, you know, because I'm named after my uncle. And my uncle Emilio, they always called him Mimi. Oh. And, you know, I've asked people... You know, I was like, where do they get that from? You know, I don't get it. Because I don't know any other Emilio called Mimi except for my uncle.
I want to know, you know, keeping the band together for 52 years now, what were the biggest challenges of keeping a band together that long? You know, I can only imagine.
Well, I think, you know, I told you I'm a recovering addict. And I think the first 20 years, the biggest challenge was myself. You know, we did everything, made every mistake possible, you know, but God had a plan for us and in spite of us. And I got sober in 88, and Doc always says, he made my life hell for a year, and I got sober in 89. Yeah, but when we got sober, that's when things changed and started kind of going back up. And but that to me was, those were the most trying things because of the addiction thing. You know, we came out of the Bay Area, late 60s, all through the 70s and the 80s, you know.
And
a lot
that's
of heart.
What was going on, you know.
That's what was going on, you know. Yeah. And it nearly undid us, but by God's grace, we're still here.
So I want to play, can I play a little clip off the latest album just so people can hear this if they haven't heard it?
Sure, absolutely.
Okay, so this is just the very beginning because this groove is... It's ridiculous.
This is Garibaldi at his best.
This is ridiculous. From the Step Up album, here it is. Okay, that's unbelievable. I mean, no one else sounds remotely close to any of that, and they couldn't, you know. Just such a sound, man. I'm such a fan.
Oh, thank you so much.
Man, it's unbelievable. Oh, man. Well, hey, I just thank you for being here tonight, and appreciate everything you've done for the music industry, the world, us musicians being inspired by you guys. And I just thank you so much, man, for everything.
My pleasure.
All right. Thanks for being here, Emilio.
Thanks for having me, Brian. God bless.
Okay. Thanks, BB. Wow. Thanks, Mimi. Hey, by the way, Tower is actually doing a gig, a drive-in gig, this Sunday, September 6th, in Ventura, California. So if you're in Southern California looking for a show, to go to a show, this Sunday, you can see Tower Power live in your car at a drive-in theater. I believe they'll be with Los Lobos as well. So it's a double bill. So check them out. Tickets, I'm sure, are on their website. So definitely go out and support because, you know, not a lot of live music going on right now. So if you're down there, go check them out this Sunday, September 6th in Ventura, California. So anywhere in SoCal, you guys can go check them out. All right, just, you know, drive up to Ventura or down from Santa Barbara, wherever you're at. Yeah. So I said earlier, I found another song in my archives, and this is, I believe it or not, I found it yesterday, and I hadn't heard this in many years, so I thought it'd be cool to bust it out tonight. It's a totally different version of the song I did with Bootsy Collins on the Bringing Back the Funk record. It went through, let me just say, it went through many iterations throughout the making of the album, and this is one of them. However, this obviously didn't make the record, so no one's heard this version, but I thought I'd bust it out tonight. Because tonight's all about the funk. Hey. So here it is. Are you ready? Uh-huh. Here it is. Oh, what?
I think it gotta be the whole beat. Oh, yeah, but double do do in a cock-a-doodle do, baby. Oh, don't you wanna ride on a function? Like fried, dry, baked on swimming pool water, baby.
What?
On a brother. Yeah, you know we're grilling. Stop the killing.
Feel the rhythm riding on the melody. Supernatural, funky as you wanna be. Carnival recording at the studio. Hypnotizing so you know it's good to go. Drop a dance in the space, bass in your face. Keep the drummer on the one like it up the place. Got the funk in my blood and it's here to stay. The Godfather James Brown showing me the way.
So now you know when to deal with us. We gon' give it to you just how you like. Every bit until you feel alright. We gon' make you feel it in your soul. Hold up, give it to him slow.
Brian tested positive.
What?
For the phone.
I tested positive.
Bye.
Tested what?
For the phone.
Oh. That was crazy. I heard that yesterday. I was like, what? Oh my goodness. That was fun. Well, there it was. Cheers, you guys. Oh, one more time. Oh, wine cam. What? There it is. There it is. Get your wine on. Get your wine on. I'm telling you, this red. Ooh, very nice, very nice. Thanks, Roger, for sending me some wine. And he could send you some wine, so don't miss out. Gotta get it, gotta get it. I'm gonna take another sip. Boy, that one hair is really sticking up, isn't it? Stay with. Hey, what are you gonna do? It's all good. But before we go, I can't believe the hour is almost over. Before we go, though, you know, we gotta sing it out. I wanna give another shout out and a huge thanks to Emilio Castillo, David Garibaldi, Larry Braggs, Euge Groove, and of course Roger Smith, and all the guys of Tower Power. Like I said, for the inspiration and for the incredible music. If you haven't seen them live, you got to experience that. Like I said, go check them out on Sunday if you're in the area. Otherwise, you got to see them next time they're around. All right? T-O-P. All about the East Bay. So thanks again, everybody. Let's sing it out. Are you ready? Oh, yeah. What? Oh! Well, there it was. I made it. We've packed it all into 1 hour. Can you believe it? I cannot. We made it happen. Oh, my goodness. Sang it.
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
That's right. Still Friday night.
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
Saturday morning in Japan. Hey, check this out. Next week, totally flipping it up. 60 minutes of BC slow jams. That's right, I said it. Slow jams.
It's Friday night.
Oh! I'm reaching back to the archives.
It's Friday night.
Slow jams from back in the day. What?
It's Friday night.
Night, 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 night.
It's Friday night.
Oh, yeah, I can't wait. Uh-huh. Oh, there it is. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Thanks for hanging out with me each and every week. I so appreciate you very, very much. We'll see you next Friday. And I'll see you right now in the chat for the post show. Later. All right. Well, check this out. We got a winner from OWC. Did you know I'm giving away this amazing USB-C dock once again tonight? And we have a winner. If you were signed up on the Hang.TV's email list, you're automatically entered to win each and every week. So this week, the winner of this USB-C travel dock is Jerome Bartel. Jerome Bartel. Be sure to check your email this weekend. Ben Haley will email you with all the details. And you'll get this amazing USB-C travel dock from our friends at OWC. You'll get it very, very soon. So amazing travel dock. It's got all kinds of stuff. HDMI, USB 3, all kinds of stuff. Oh, it's got a card reader and all kinds of stuff. So anyway, congratulations, Jerome. Yeah, man. Let's see what's going on in the chat. Hey, everybody. Ah, yes. Oh, yeah. It's Labor Day weekend. Tell me to stay. I forgot. Yeah. Oh, yeah, the t-shirt I got on. This is a screenshot from the Mile Sauce cartoon. My friend in Italy actually had this made and brought it to me. He came to the Napa Valley Jazz Getaway a couple years ago, actually last year, and brought me this shirt. So, thanks, man. But, yeah, happy Labor Day weekend. Yeah. Enjoy the weekend. Thank you, guys. Ah, everybody's here. Hi, Kathy. How you doing? Oh, so good to see you here. Thanks for hanging out with us. Everybody's here. LaRonda's like, can a girl get a shirt? Well, I'll work on it. What are you gonna do? My hair is just as crazy on this shirt, let me tell you. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. This was so much fun. Again, thanks to TLP. Guys are amazing. Yeah, next week, 60 minutes straight of slow jams. I'm breaking them all out. All your favorites. Mm-hmm. Timothy, we'll see. We'll see. Okay. thanks, Diane. I'll work on the tea. Okay. It's going to be all right. It's going to be okay. Okay, Kim. I hear you. I hear you. Oh, Andrew's going to Tower this weekend. Very cool, man. I'm sure it's going to be amazing. So I wish I could be there. Wish I could be there. Jeslyn, thank you. Thanks, Linda. Hey, Tamara. What's going on? All right. Terry Scott. Everybody is here. Thanks, you guys. Seesaw, I'll see you Sunday. And see you guys next Friday, if not sooner. Later.